that to our credibility if we change everything again in the process and just keep changing and changing and changing how we're doing things? And we've already said this is what we've done. There's already been a motion. We've already started the process. There's nothing saying that we can't listen to them and then say, you know, we're not happy with either one, let's start this again. But
I suggest that we just go ahead and invite the others.
So all four of them will be on the 17th?
Well, I don't know that they can come on the 17th. I mean, it does take time to arrange those arrangements. But that is a possibility. Yeah.
I agree with Mr. Hadley on most of what he said. I think it's pretty absurd to pick an attorney that we're terminating the same one to represent us. And it's also two counselors that are no longer on the council choosing an attorney to represent all of us. That doesn't make sense to me. Why we would have two people that aren't here choosing an attorney.
I would remind council that the attorney's firm that that we currently have has more than one attorney in there, and that we could go with a different attorney under that umbrella. So that is something to remember as we're talking about that. It's not just that person.
The other thing I wanted to bring up was that maybe it would be appropriate to have a work session to discuss our opinions and what we're looking for an attorney, so that it is.
I mean, my opinion on this is that I think there has to be some continuity with councils. Councils has decided something, and we can't recreate the wheel every time. I understand that we are a brand new council. I also understand the frustration, because I'm frustrated with having to interview an attorney's firm that we are in the process of trying to find a replacement for, which to me, while I understand there are multiple attorneys in a firm, it's still that firm. And perhaps I'm just not as savvy about that as I should be. Having gone through the process already, have the benefit of having looked at the other ones, so I kind of know what I'm looking at. But I do understand that you haven't, and you have a decision to make for the community. So I would be opposed to doing it over. But I don't want to start all over again. There may be some, we may be able to send out some RFPs again, a request for an RFP, for example, for LCOG has attorneys that we can use, that we can get an RFP. We can do that, and then look at those that have applied, and there was four of them, I believe, and invite them to come and speak, although I think you'd want to look at them first. There was a reason why the committee chose not to move forward on one of them, for sure. But you need to see that for yourself.
I understand that. And the problem that I see is if you don't fix your problem and you keep pacifying the problems you have with the same attorney that we've had for 20-something years, I think these councils shouldn't be listening to what the last council put in front of them. I think they should be able to judge it on their self. Because in League of Oregon City, when I spent my time there, I did ask the attorney, and I did ask several different city administrators.
Well, I don't think we have an argument about whether we want to replace our attorney. We're just looking at what the process is. We've already determined that, and we're going to do that.
To bring them here.
And what we've done, what you're saying is you would like to have more interviews than just the two that we have set up, and expand those interviews to those that have also applied. Is that a good way of putting what it is that you want?
Yes.
Go ahead.
I think we should take the two we have on the 17th and see if we can't get the other two to apply to and pick for something in the middle of February. See if there's any other two that we didn't.
Okay. At their earliest.
Go back and
do you have any thoughts on that, Mr. Messina?
What I can do is, obviously with council directions, I can reach out to the other two attorney firms that were not selected to see if they're available for the January 17th meeting to also come to your presentation. Okay. If they can't, we'll schedule them for the 21st if that's what we're doing.
Yeah, we know.
I'd
like
that.
So, Mr. In the meantime, times could you give all the councils RFPs for them?
Yes.
That is.
It's a significant pile of reading, but you can all have.
I have them all. That, to me, this is very important, that this council needs to look at this. Judge.
I hesitate to say this, but as a citizen of this community, I heard all of you say you wanted to move forward and make the city better. What I'm hearing tonight is you're wanting to go backwards and change everything that's already been done. And I'm not saying that what's been done wasn't right, or was right, or whatever, but how much time are you willing to spend going backwards and fixing all these things that you think they did wrong, instead of moving forward and going forward with it? And I don't want to argue it with anybody, and I'm just saying that it just seems like that's what we're doing here tonight, is we're just saying that what the council that set up there before all of you did wasn't good enough, and now you want to go back and change it all. And I just, as a citizen, that bothers me.
Thank you, Rhett. Thank you. So, we've discussed this. We have, obviously, we're not comfortable with interviewing just the two attorneys. That seems to be a consensus with everyone.
No, I'm fine.
You're fine with moving.
I'm fine with moving forward with what the previous council has already done.
Okay.
You too, love.
All right. I do appreciate with what Rusty said. I do think that it is important to move forward and get a new attorney, but I also think that we do have to be cognizant of the fact that we cannot go back and correct what wrongs we think were done, even in procedure. It's one thing to look at an audit of the attorney to make sure that there isn't money owed back to the city. It's another thing to rethink and redo previous council's decisions. Council voted, council made a decision to move forward. So I would, that's my opinion, and it doesn't hold any more weight than yours does. No, I'm not gonna recognize. You have to make this decision yourselves. So, if you have a motion to present, you present it.
I make a motion that we get the RFPs for the four.
Wait a minute. Jackie, do we have a motion on the table?
Yes.
Got
it. Did we vote on that?
We would like to have the four.
So you want
RFPs given to the council to review. Select by the 17th?
Yeah.
By the 17th?
If possible.
Can I make a suggestion that we do this at that we give up those and then discuss them at a work session so that we can do that? We still have two that are coming to meet with us and talk to us on the 17th, but that doesn't mean you can't review the ones that have come in that you didn't choose. We can have a meeting. We could do a work session on a Saturday to just look at these quickly. You want to do that? Go ahead and keep the two that we're having interviewed with the remainder and determine from those who you would like to interview.
Can we do the work session soon? Before
we could do the work session soon. Before the 17th. We still won't get anybody on the 17th to come, probably. But we definitely do that. Except for the two that we already have. And those will be those. And then we'll do a work session and review the ones from there, Bobby.
Before we keep moving this discussion forward in this direction, I feel that it's important to find out what's been communicated with these attorneys and these firms I mean, if we've communicated with them and told them that this is where we're at, we're asking you to come present, we're wanting to make this selection to this point, I mean, we're really back to, where's our credibility with all of this? I mean, if we keep going in this circle and we're chasing our tails, and like you said, redoing things, I mean, really, what have we communicated with the attorneys? What have we told them? What are their expectations at this point? I mean, are they watching our council meetings? Or are they paying attention to what they're asking, what they might be jumping into with our city? Mm-hmm. I mean, hopefully. I feel like we are definitely moving backwards.
So your question is, what have the other attorneys been told? That
what have all the attorneys been told? Not just the two that we selected and the two that weren't selected. But what have all of them been told?
Firms were told that they were selected to go forward to make presentations in front of the city council. Just ask them to discuss their municipal law background and experience with council and be ready for questions. The other two, I just said they were not selected at this time to be interviewed.
So what does that speak to?
I think what we need to do is look at those other two that were asked and see if any of them aren't ones that you would like to ask, and if so, then do so. And ask them. We already have two on the books. That's a good start. There's no reason why we can't expand it to be larger. But I do think that we need to move forward here and decide what we want to do. So, let's finish with your motion then to get all of the RFPs given to the council.
Well, one of the things I'd like to address to you and everybody else, there was an election this year. That's why all these people are new up here. The council that was here is not here no longer. So there had to be, I agree with Rusty, there has to be something go forward. I am 100% behind that. But you're putting the council up here, five brand new people, that absolutely don't have anything to do with the past. We understand what has been going on. Mr. Messina, I understand the turmoil he has.
So,
just like
Hadley, I'm going to stop you because I think at this point, what you can do as a council, we can choose to make a decision to change our process in moving forward, or we can choose to leave it the same as it is, and then when it comes time to listen to those, choose not to hire those two and move on. There is a process for doing that. So, at this point, I think what we need to do is move forward with a motion and ask the city administrator to give the RFPs that were received to all of the council so that they can look at them. We can set up a date to discuss them and see if there are any of those out of that pool that we also would like to interview in addition to the two that we are already interviewing. Does that make sense?
That's fine.
Okay. So, I can make a motion, Candace, if you do.
Is that the motion?
There's already a motion on the floor.
So, yeah. So the motion is to give to the city council the RFPs that have been received, to interview the two on the 17th that have been already scheduled, and to set a work session time for the council to choose any others that they would also like to interview.
A second.
Okay, motion, please.
Well, I thought you
I mean,
motion.
Sorry,
second.
Vote. Vote,
Councilor
guys.
Councilor Whitney.
Okay. Councilor Barron-Boyd.
Aye.
Councilor Borkum.
Aye.
To
Chrissy, what did you want to discuss on the committee?
I was hoping we could set up a work session to review all the city's committees. I was hoping that staff could provide us a list of them, what their job duties are, their responsibilities, just kind of give us a overview of what those committees entail. That way, when we select, not hire, when we select an applicant, we know what we're selecting for.
Congratulations.
And I've heard that some of these committees need to be restructured, so I was hoping that would be a time where we could hear input from people on how to restructure them. If they, maybe they don't need to restructure. And I also was hoping for kind of a explanation of what the process is for somebody when they come in and apply for a committee, who they make their application to, what happens to it after that point, how does it get to council.
So you could add that to a list.
Yeah.
That sounds good.
And all of that, all those committees that were on the agenda for today.
So you're asking for a work session?
Correct.
Yeah.
To get more information on the committee process here in Oakridge and how committees are formed, what their purposes are, and how council interacts with those committees.
And also if there's a kind of a guideline for each committee, if that exists.
So do we have a consensus? Does everybody agree that they would like to see that done? To do a work session for that? If I show the nod of hands, show whatever, yes, we all agree on it. So there is a consensus that we want to do that.
Generally, wouldn't this be part of a community advisory board? We would oversee the various committees and then report to the council?
Well, that's a good thought. You should bring that with you when we have our work session.
I will.
Thank you.
No pat in hand.
Excellent idea.
So, in addition to what Chris is asking for, I think it would be nice to also see who's responsible for what in these committees.
Mm-hmm.
And any dates that any assignments are due.
So you want a list of existing committees, assignments and terms, and vacancies.
And more than just committees, because we have boards.
I think
we have board agreements.
Well,
we have a lot of big projects going on within the city.
So what are you referring to?
Well,
the TSP?
There's that, but I mean, there's little projects. We've had little meetings like about the hearings and all these little different things. I don't even know what all is out there.
Okay.
I would like to know that.
Okay.
Who's responsible and
so make
it a little
bit broader.
Yeah.
If there are committees that are meeting with the guidance of City Hall or City Council has asked to do, we would like to see those.
Yes.
Okay. So it has something to do with the city.
Yes.
So one of the problems I have, when you go on the website to find any of these committees and things that there is, and I look at it, it's not been updated.
Right.
And I think the city, somebody, I don't know who's responsible for updating that, but I think the website should be brought back up so we can go and see ordinances you can't see in the committees and you can't
see
them.
So I think I would suggest to you that you put some thought into what you would like to see with that, and then in the future, ask that be put on an agenda item so that we can discuss it. That's a big. That is a big topic. Now we are running out of time, guys. So, so we have consensus that we would like staff to do that.
Good.
Also, then is there another one that's up, Bonnie? Or that's all right. You should be.
Is it okay?
Yes, please.
Reports 7.7. For council rules, I would like to suggest that we have a work session and make it be one of our very first work sessions to develop a set of council rules for this council of how it's going to operate. Something that's a little more detailed that outlines all the different pieces that impact city council.
Mm-hmm.
And have something that's transparent, and I'd like to see it be a resolution because that's something that can easily be amended and adjusted as needed based on the needs of the city and the council, the citizens, and everybody, and find something that has a clear and consistent process that gives us more transparency and redefines everybody's expectations. And
good. I mean, that's a lot of. I mean, can we have a council consensus on that? Do you all agree that that's something you'd like to see?
So we have a lot of good additions for work sessions. I'll remind you that our process for doing agendas for work sessions and business meetings, our first meeting will always be a work session, our second meeting in the month will always be a business meeting. But that doesn't mean, because we have so many things that we need to learn and do, that we can't have work sessions in between. And we're willing to do that. Okay, that's awesome. So we can do that. So can we look at your calendars then? And do you have a Saturday or a Sunday between now and the 17th, or even 18th, 19th, or 20th, that you have available?
I'm open anytime.
You're open anytime.
13th, 19th,
I like
20th.
That. So we have, Paul, you have a work session.
12. I can't
yeah.
do the 12.
What? 12? You can't do the 12.
Yep.
But you can do the 13th.
Yep.
And you can do the 19th or the 20th.
Yep.
So that's a Sunday or a Saturday or the next Saturday or Sunday.
The 13th, 19th, and 20th.
13th, 19th, or 20th.
So what are our priorities for those work sessions? Have we put three on the tables?
All three.
All three work sessions on one day?
Yeah, we can get to them.
Okay. Well, I still think that's possible. However, I think you're wonderful, and I'm so glad that you are eager to do all that. However, I think that's a huge bite to take off. And we need to be a little cognizant of what we can and cannot do.
Could we set a time frame, 3 hours, and then we get through what we get through?
We could do that. However, what that also means is that we have staff that need to prepare information for us on this. And so I am more than willing to say that we'll do two.
Well, we just put a timeline on and get to what we can, and the next one just continue where we left off.
We can do that, and let's see how the staff goes. With the understanding that staff has to put time into this, and that is asking an awful lot of them also when they're doing other things. And Mr. Messina's.
Mayor, it strikes me that as much as I think that the discussion about committees and the committee roles is important, that seems to be one we can push down the road a little bit.
Okay.
Probably at this, you can talk to your rules of council and the attorneys.
Okay,
attorney.
Let's stick with those two and push the committees down to another work session at a later date. Maybe we can do that on the first meeting in March, which will be a work session.
So the attorney.
In February.
No, March for the committees.
So that means.
Oh yeah. Okay.
That means we wouldn't fill those vacancies until the end of March.
Yeah, if you want to learn this and have time, I mean, we can certainly look back at that and say we can do it sooner by having a work session sometime in February, too.
How long are we advertising those?
Long to take.
Well, we have to set a deadline.
Night, 3 months.
Okay, so we have a consensus that we want to do these work sessions. We're set.
Yeah, so the attorney stuff and the council rules.
Council rules, and the last would be the committees.
Yeah.
Okay.
On the 19th at the end of time.
And, so thank you. 19th?
13th.
13th is a Sunday?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's do the 13th then. And what time do you want to meet on the 13th?
4 to 6.
4 to 6?
Yeah,
that works. 4 to 7.
4 to 6 p.m.
Yes. 4 to 7,
yeah. And we're going to look at primarily council rules and the attorney piece at that point,
right?
Right?
Yep.
Okay. 13, okay. 4 to 6 p.m.
Yep.
January on your calendars. Excellent. One more thing we have to bring up is council.
Oh.
Yes.
We need to tell them where at.
Oh, at City Hall.
City Hall. You guys want to go upstairs?
Okay. Is the charter requires that we look at a council president on the first meeting of the month. So we can look at that and we can choose to vote on that if you would like to.